Hello everyone, I finished reading We Have Always Lived in the Castle by Shirley Jackson, and I must say I really, really liked it. It's a very different book. It's unlike what you think it would be, but it still has this huge capacity to satisfy you when you're reading it. It was first published in 1962. Shirley Jackson, as we all know, is a very famous author, and no one can really doubt her writing capabilities. I had long time back read The Haunting of the Hill House, and then I also watched the show, which is a phenomenal show by all means. And I was thinking that it might have kind of similar tones or lines, but it doesn't. It is a very, very, very gothic story, there's no doubt about it, but the book has its ways of teasing you with supernatural themes and ideas while maintaining a complete absence of it, and that is something which is really masterfully done in this book. It's essentially a story about the Blackwoods, who live in their huge mansion, which is supposed to be very beautiful as they have described in the book, and they have a kind of past, and it kind of keeps haunting them in ways. There's a young girl named Catherine Blackwood, who's constantly referred to as Mary Cat in the book, elder sister Constance, and their uncle. Now, these are the three main characters who are there in the story, and they have a cousin who comes to visit them, and the whole story kind of progresses then. There had been some murders in the family, and it's kind of kept hanging in the air that who was the murderer and what actually happened. And then finally towards the end of the book you get to know what had actually happened, but that essentially is not the plot of the book. The book actually doesn't really have a plot, if you really want to put it like that. It's not a thriller mystery kind of a thing. What it aims at is, it aims to make you feel a lot of things which you may not be thinking about before. When I was reading this book, there was a tsunami of feelings that I was hit with while reading the book. It deals with the idea of alienating people, shunning them out of your society, and then there is this tricky question that should that be done or should that not be done, and if they had done something really, really hideous, then it should have been done or it should not have been done. It really very effectively makes you feel the things that it intends to. It's a very thin and it's a very simply written book. Like, if even if you look at the size, it's hardly around I believe 200 pages. It's not even 200 pages, it's 146 pages, and you can easily go through this in a single sitting. It's not a very fat book, and it is written very simply. It does not make use of very heavy language, or you might feel that okay, these are certain words which I need to keep flipping the dictionary for. It's very simply written, and the best part is it is so beautifully written, it is so aesthetically written that it makes you feel that yes, this is something really beautiful that you're reading. That was the first thing that struck me when I started reading the book. That was the first thing that got me hooked on to this book. The book is very gothic in its feel, so if you have a thing for gothic literature, I'm sure you're going to enjoy this book. But I would recommend this book for everyone, because I think it's really well written book, and I hope you guys will enjoy reading it. Just one thing I would like to repeat again, that it's not a book which is driven by a plot. So it's not something which is a thriller, and if you're looking for something like that, then this book is not your cup of tea. Also, do not pick up this book thinking that there are going to be a lot of ghosts and spirits and stuff like that, as you might expect after watching the show or reading the other book, which is Haunting of the Hill House. So that is one thing you need to stay clear about, but this is definitely a magnificent book, and I think you should definitely read this. The edition that I have is a Penguin Classic Deluxe edition, and it's a beautiful cover, and it's really well produced. It's got darker edges, and the cover art is done by Thomas Ott, and it's a really nice pen rendering of a few characters. It's a French flap book. I think the book in its production, this particular edition, is so beautiful that it that was also another factor that that pulled me to pick up this particular copy. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please subscribe to this channel. I'll be putting up more content like this based on books and movies and TV shows. Thank you.